Hello and welcome to NewsClick. I'm Sumedha, and today we're bringing you a glimpse of some of the most important stories that we report about at NewsClick. Supreme Court Judge AK Sikri has turned down the offer of the Modi government to become the president of the Commonwealth Secretariat Arbitral Tribunal. It is interesting to note that AK Sikri was a member of the three-panel committee which had actually proposed to remove Alok Verma as the CBI director. In the past few days, many critics of the Modi government have actually questioned if Sikri's nomination was actually a reward being given out to him in the help that he gave to remove Alok Verma. Opposition also came from Rahul Gandhi, who alleged that the Modi government was stooping to protect itself from the Rafael deal probe. Following the controversy, Justice Sikri wrote to the Modi government, withdrawing his consent for the appointment. Delhi Police's special cell has finalized a draft charge sheet surrounding the sedition case in JNU. The charge sheet names 10 people, including student leaders such as Kanhiaya Kumar, Umar Khalid and Anirvan Bhattacharya. The draft charge sheet comes almost 3 years after the first FIR was registered against the students. The investigating officer in the case has identified 8 Kashmiri students, which also includes 2 brothers. Questioning was also done for Umar Khalid and other students' statements were also recorded. Kanhiaya Kumar's lawyer, Vrinda Grover, has stated that she was not aware of any updates on the charge sheet. She has also gone ahead to say that this is a politically motivated case ahead of the 2019 elections. She also went on to state that this was a clear misuse of the process as well as the police in the political arena. She also highlighted that since the very beginning, the allegations appeared to be fabricated. Following this, the opposition has also slammed the police for acting at the behest of the BJP. Residents from a small Palamu district of Jharkhand are amassing resistance against the Duntuta mines. The residents have been alleging that their land was taken away from them forcefully. The locals have been sitting on a dharna for the past 4 days. However, their struggle goes back to 3 years. The locals allege that the mines are situated right next to the village, causing them severe problems. The locals are also stating that this is a case of land acquisition, as the mines were initially supposed to be around the area of 9 acres. However, forceful land acquisition has spread the area to about 25 acres. The locals have also alleged that there is firing and hooliganism by the owner of the mines, who happens to be a powerful leader called Anjani Kumar. Interpol has arrested Italian author and militant Cesare Battisti at the instigation of the Brazilian president Jair Bolsonaro. Battisti happens to be a member of the left group Armed Proletarians for Communism. He was in exile since 1981 and is also charged with 4 murders, a charge which he has refuted. Bolsonaro's son tweeted that the arrest was actually a gift for far-right leader and Interior Minister Matteo Salvini. The arrest actually comes as no surprise, with Bolsonaro and his allies expressing their intent to target the left in Brazil. Observers in Brazil had feared that Bolsonaro's presidency would actually lead to the increase in the right-wing militia in the country. They had also suggested that he would deliberately try to target the left-wing activists who are opposed to his neoliberal policies. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. To follow these stories and many more, log on to our website www.newsclick.in. Also subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on Facebook.